Hello everybody, and today in this video I will compare the difference between the Axis MLPU camera and the Axis DLPU cameras. Let's get started. So this one is a machine learning processing unit camera. This is a P3245 and it's using an RPEX 7 chip. This one right here is an M3086V. It has a deep learning processing unit as well as this one. But this one has an Ambarella CV25, and this one's the P3265V, which has an Axis RPEX 8 chip, which is the newest flagship chip out there. Alright, so the P3245 and the P3267 on a tripod, and I don't have a third tripod, so I propped my M386 on an Axis camera there, and all images are level, as you can see. This is the image of the M386, the flagpole is straight, so that's good. Also for my P3245, there we go, the flagpole is straight. And P3265, the flagpole is also straight to give it a fair chance of detecting. And also all the cameras are zoomed out. There we go, that's on the minimum zoom. Same on my P3245. And the M386 does not have any zoom because that's a fixed lens, so yeah. But it actually has double the megapixel count, so I think at this angle it's wider, but it also has double the megapixel count, so I think that's fair. As you can see here on P3245, I've set this in object in area. Same thing on the P3265 and the M3086. Alright, so now let's go ahead and let's go test it. And here's how I would test the cameras. So I have four lighting scenarios, from daylight, after sunset, at night with the help of a 8-watt 1-watt bulb, and then at night with only the help of the moon. And then the posture for the detection would be walking normally and crawling. The crawling is included here because of the new feature of DLPU, which can detect unusual human position. Unlike the MLPU, which actually says that it can only detect human walking normally only. Alright, so for the camera wheel order, I will show the P3245 first, then the P3265, and then the last one will be the M3086. And for the ranking, I rank two things: time to first detection and detection consistency. So for the time to first detection, which is measured in second, the lower the time, the better. The best one will rank first and the worst one will rank third place. And for the detection consistency, if the detection bounding box can keep up with me walking or crawling throughout the video feed, then that is very consistent, and the more consistent it is, the better. And the ranking is the same as the last one. Best one get first and worst one get third. So now with the criteria out of the way, let's get to testing. Alright, so the time is now 2:12 PM on 18th April 2024. As you can see, it's very very sunny out here. Let's go walk, pop this fence, and then go into the flagpole, which is the furthest spawn, and go back here. And I will do another half distance for the M386V because it has a wider field of view. So let's get started. We'll be right back. And here's the ranking for the daylight scenario. Alright, and as you can see, it's now way past sunset. As you can see, there's no sun left, and it's getting a little bit dark, but not much. It's now 8:04. As you can see that, the P3245 and the P3265 gives super beautiful image. Color rendition are very, very nice. While the M3A6 still gives a beautiful image, but it's way wider and has like some blown out artifact right here. So now let's proceed to the sunset test. And here's a sunset scenario ranking for the three cameras. Alright, so 10 hours, 836, as you can see that the sky is getting really, really dark. You can barely see my two camera and the 386 there. So this next test is going to be with the warm white light, 8 watts, 2700K. And as you can see that the P3245 looks pretty bright, no problem there. Same with the P3265 because it uses the same sensor and the same lens. And the M3A6 is a little bit darker, but I have increased the shutter speed a little bit due to this one being a 4 megapixel imager and the 3245 and the 3265 being 2 megapixel with the same 1 over 2.7 inch sensor size.
Thank you.
And here's the ranking for the night with 8 watt light scenario. Alright, so the time is now 8:41 PM. As you can see, the sky is getting really, really dark. I'm using a Sony HDR CX7, so the sensor may not be the best, but this is what it looks like with my eyes too. You can see some faint moonlight right there from the moon, which is way up there. There we go. And let's see on our Lightfighter 2.0 contender, Peter 245. It looks really, really good, even though there's like no light there because I've turned off the light in my kitchen. And the same for Peter 265 because you see the same sensor. There we go. Maybe just a little bit darker for some reason, but still legible. There we go. You can actually see the grass down there. And for the M386, yeah, this is only Lightfighter 1.0, and I've increased the shutter to 1/15, 42 dB for Lightfighter 1.0. It's not that great, but well, we'll see how it performs like in total darkness, except for the moonlight, of course. And finally, here's the ranking for the night with only moonlight scenario. And here's the final ranking, and the first leg goes to the P3265. The RPA DLPU and Lightfighter 2.0 really does help to bring up the brightness of the image, and also has great detection and tracking consistency throughout all scenarios. Even the one that was in very, very low light, such as the last one, which being the moonlight, I really didn't expect it to detect and track me in the moonlight, but yeah, it did. And the second place go to the P3245. That's an older chip, which is an ArcPack 7, and only has machine learning, but really performed better than expected, especially in the sunset and the daylight scenario when I have unusual human position. It was able to track it and detect it just fine. Hit or miss detection and tracking in low light though, so yeah. It's only a machine learning processing unit, so I won't put too much weight on it. And the third place goes to M386. Even though it has a DLPU, it's a CV25, and the detection rate is not great, and tracking is a hit or miss in low light. Also, the image quality isn't that great in low light either. And that's the end of the video. And as always, thank you for watching.